Thank you very much. Namaskar. Good evening. I will follow the same format that I did yesterday. First of all, I have a brief note on today's BIMSTEC ministerial meeting. I will read that out first of all. Then I will take your question, both in English and Nepali. Please feel free to ask the questions, whatever language you feel comfortable. Thank you very much, dear colleagues from the media. Good evening to you all. I welcome you to this briefing. I begin by thanking you for the continuous cooperation ever since we began engaging in the BIMSTEC summit process. Today, I am here to brief you on the 16th BIMSTEC ministerial meeting that successfully concluded today. The meeting was chaired by Minister for Foreign Affairs of Nepal, Honorable Pradeep Kumar Gyawali. The meeting was held in an atmosphere of utmost cordiality and spirit of cooperation. As you all know, the meeting was preceded by the 19th session of the BIMSTEC Senior Officials Meeting, which was held yesterday. You have already been briefed about the outcome of the Senior Officials Meeting in the press briefing yesterday here. The meeting was attended by Foreign Minister of People's Republic of Bangladesh, Honorable Abul Hassan Mahmud Ali, Foreign Secretary of the Royal Government of Bhutan, His Excellency Ambassador Sonam Chong, Minister of State for External Affairs of the Republic of India, General Dr. V. K. Singh, Union Minister for International Cooperation of the Republic of the Union of Myanmar, Honorable Yu Kyo Tin, Minister for Foreign Affairs of Nepal, Honorable Pradeep Kumar Gyawali, State Minister for Foreign Affairs of Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka, Honorable Basanta Senanayake, and Foreign Minister of Kingdom of Thailand, Honorable Don Pramud Viani. The meeting began with the country statements by the Foreign and External Affairs Ministers and the heads of the delegation of the BIMSTEC member states. In his opening remarks, Minister for Foreign Affairs, Honorable Pradeep Kumar Gyawali, stated that the BIMSTEC is a unique regional platform because of its history, geographical contiguity, great civilizational links, and existence of potentials that can contribute to transform it into a prosperous region. The foreign minister highlighted the challenges of poverty, hunger, backwardness, inequality, natural disasters, environmental degradation, terrorism, organized crimes, illicit drugs and human trafficking, and he also called for a serious introspection on the part of all the member states of the BIMSTEC. Foreign Minister Honorable Gyawali also stressed on the need to deepen rather than proliferate the areas of cooperation and called for rationalizing the priority areas and focus on connectivity, trade, tourism, energy, and agriculture. The Foreign Minister called for early conclusion of negotiations under the BIMSTEC Free Trade Agreement, expressed satisfaction that a master plan on transport connectivity is being developed, an MOU on grid interconnections will be signed, and he called on for the defeating of terrorism and combat other transnational organized crimes. The ministerial meeting reviewed the whole gamut of the cooperation under the BIMSTEC and decided to further consolidate regional cooperation process. The ministers reiterated their commitments to make BIMSTEC process more effective and result-oriented. The meeting considered report of the Secretary General of BIMSTEC. In his report, the Secretary General highlighted the progress of the BIMSTEC in terms of setting up institutions, laying down legal framework, initiating project-based cooperation, facilitating capacity building and knowledge sharing, and enhancing contacts and exchanges at various levels among member states. He underlined that the establishment of BIMSTEC Permanent Secretariat in Bangladesh, BIMSTEC Cultural Industries Observatory in Bhutan, and BIMSTEC Center for Weather and Climate in India as some of the key achievements in terms of institutional development. He also reported that efforts are underway to operationalize BIMSTEC Energy Center in India and BIMSTEC Technology Transfer Facility in Sri Lanka. The Secretary General reported that the Trade Negotiating Committee has held 20 rounds of negotiation to operationalize BIMSTEC Free Trade Area Framework Agreement. As you all may know that BIMSTEC FTA was signed in 2004. The Secretary General reported the progress made to finalize the draft text of few other new agreements. They were agreement on cooperation and mutual assistance in customs matters, BIMSTEC Motor Vehicles Agreement, BIMSTEC Coastal Shipping Agreement, and the draft text of the Trade Facilitation Agreement. These proposed agreements are in different stages of consultation among the member states. The Secretary General also reported that the member states are developing BIMSTEC Transport Connectivity Master Plan with the target to complete it by the end of September 2018, this year. In the ministerial meeting, the ministers reviewed the progress in priority areas of cooperation since holding of the 15th BIMSTEC ministerial meeting held in Kathmandu last year in August. Foreign Secretary of Nepal, in his capacity as the chair of the senior officials meeting, presented the report of the special session of BIMSTEC senior officials meeting held in Kathmandu on the 11th of this month, and the report of the 19th session of the BIMSTEC senior officials meeting held yesterday. The meeting considered and endorsed both the reports. The ministers endorsed the text of the draft summit declaration and recommended that to the leaders of the BIMSTEC member states for their approval. The ministers expressed their readiness to sign the memorandum of understanding on the establishment of BIMSTEC grid interconnection. As you all know, that senior officials meeting yesterday had recommended the final text of the MOU for signature during this summit. While appreciating the progress achieved in the past, the ministers resolved to take more vigorous steps for focused implementation of the activities in the organization. They felt the need for rationalization of priority areas and focusing on more core economic sectors to make BIMSTEC more effective, result-oriented, and to enhance its visibility. As per the BIMSTEC practice, the Foreign Minister of Nepal handed over the chairmanship of the BIMSTEC ministerial meeting to the State Minister for Foreign Affairs of Sri Lanka. The ministers appreciated Sri Lanka for acceptance to assume the next chairmanship of BIMSTEC ministerial meeting. The meeting also discussed on the status of the progress and achievement in the 14 areas of cooperation under BIMSTEC. The leaders of the delegation urged for the early operationalization of the established mechanisms and BIMSTEC centers. The 17th ministerial meeting of the BIMSTEC will be held in Sri Lanka. The dates will be finalized through diplomatic channel. With these notes, I thank you all for your attention. Now I will take your questions. Please feel free to ask the questions in either in English or in Nepali. Before you present your question, please kindly introduce yourself. Thank you.
Sir, this is Sarath Bhandari from Official News Agency of this country, that's National News Agency. You did not mention during your briefing about the initiation or establishment of BIMSTEC Development Fund. Is there any lacuna?
Saraji, perhaps you might have noticed that this the initiative or the process for the establishment of BIMSTEC Development Fund was deliberated extensively and was endorsed by the senior officials meeting yesterday. And since the ministers, they deliberated on that report today and endorsed it, that means that that element is within that report. That issue did not figure out in the meeting today. Please.
Sir, Siddhant from Beyond, my question is on terror. How much terror will be the focus when the leaders meet tomorrow, starting tomorrow? And what went on today when the ministers meet on the issue of terror? Was state sponsorship of terror was also discussed by the ministers?
Perhaps you might understand that fighting terrorism is one of the areas of cooperation in BIMSTEC, and that matter, when they discuss that matter, naturally it comes into the discussion also. And it was discussed during the senior officials meeting yesterday, and since the ministers endorsed the report of the senior officials meeting, that matter figured out in the meeting today as well. I think the issues or anything about SAARC did not figure out in the meeting today.
As a neighboring country, China has shown interest to cooperate with you. You say that there are some media reports?
Thank you for that question. Actually, I am briefing you about what happened in today's ministerial meeting of the BIMSTEC. So, as far as I understand, I cannot comment what appeared in the media.
Please. What will be the main agenda for tomorrow?
I have two point answer to that. Probably by late evening today, we will be posting in our website the agenda for the summit tomorrow. I would suggest you to consult in that. And second thing, BIMSTEC has very defined areas of cooperation. So those areas of cooperation are the main agendas for the meeting. I am not aware of that. I do not have information on that.
Sir, could you please shed light on the bilateral meetings as well, because we have very limited access. So, I have come to know that bilateral meetings do have taken place. So, gratefully if we could shed light on that.
Thank you, Saraji. Of course, when heads of states and governments meet in such a forum, naturally there is a practice of having different bilateral meetings at the margin of the meeting. So during this BIMSTEC summit also, there are different bilateral meetings between and among the member states going on. And a while ago, there was a bilateral meeting between Right Honorable Prime Minister of Nepal and His Excellency, the head of the government of Royal Government of Bhutan. And there are other bilateral meetings planned as well. I do not have that details at the moment with me, but I can share with you later in appropriate time. काफलेजी त्यो मिटिङमा अरु कामको कारणले गर्दाखेरि म आफू उपस्थित हुन पाएको थिइनँ. त्यसो हुनाले त्यसको डिटेल मसँग अहिले उपलब्ध छैन. मैले त्यसमा उपस्थित हुने हाम्रो साथीहरूसँगबाट लिएर म सेयर गरौँला पछि. यस्तो छ, म दिपाजीलाई कसरी भनौँ भनेदेखि, वास्तवमा हिजोको मिटिङमा सारै हिजोको मिटिङलाई चाहिँ हामीले यसअगाडि अगस्त 11 तारिकमा भएको सोमसँग पनि जोड्नुपर्ने हुन्छ। त्यतिखेर भएको सिनियर अफिसियल्स मिटिङ र हिजो भएको सिनियर अफिसियल्स मिटिङ यी दुईटा मिटिङहरूले चाहिँ बिम्स्टेक समिटको डिक्लेरेसन र अरू एजेन्डाहरूको बारेमा चाहिँ डिटेलमा डेलिभरेसन गरेको थियो। त्यो डिटेलमा डेलिभरेसन गरेको हुनाले चाहिँ हिजो यी कुराहरू चाहिँ फाइनलाइज गर्न सजिलो पनि भयो। त्यस कारणले चाहिँ डिक्लेरेसनको टेक्स्ट चाहिँ त्यो फाइनल भएको छ र आज मन्त्रीस्तरीय बैठकमा त्यो टेक्स्टको बारेमा पनि छलफल भएर त्यो हिजो रिकमेन्ड भएको टेक्स्टलाई चाहिँ उहाँहरूले नेतृत्वहरू समक्ष चाहिँ प्रस्तुत गर्ने गरेर सहमत हुनुभएको छ। तर त्यहाँभित्रको कन्टेन्ट के छ भन्ने कुरा चाहिँ इट इज अ प्रेरोगेटिभ अफ द समिट, सो आई डु नट ह्याभ डिटेल्स एट दिस स्टेज। अरू यतातिर यहाँहरूसँग केही छ प्रश्न? यसमा के छ भने मैले अहिले पढेको चाहिँ यो जुन नोट छ नि त्यो हामीले हाम्रो वेबसाइटमा चाहिँ पोस्ट गरिदिन्छौँ। एउटा अर्को चाहिँ यसलाई हामीले हाम्रो मेलिङ लिस्टमा जो जो हुनुहुन्छ उहाँहरूलाई चाहिँ इमेलबाट पनि सर्कुलेट गर्छौँ हामीहरूले, त्यही नै हो। आज मिनिस्टेरियल मिटिङमा त सबै मन्त्रीज्यूहरूले चाहिँ एड्रेस गर्नुभएको छ। त्यो उहाँहरूले के भन्नुभयो भन्ने कुराहरू चाहिँ त सरस्वती मैले मेरो नोटमा चाहिँ मेन्सन गरेको छु।